I've got with me in the studio today Kevin Van Vogt from Cradle Arc. Kevin, nice to see you.
Thanks very much, Andrew.
It's been a busy week of announcements from you. Of course, a couple of days back you had that operational and production guidance announcement for 2018, just this morning to your 2017 results. Let's kick off with those earlier announcements. What is the latest on the ground at Mowana? How are things coming along?
Andrew, in April of this year, we launched our accelerated development plan. What was important for us was to get the mining up to speed, generating space in the open cast operations, and start yielding some of the ores that are part of our mining plan. We started processing at the end of May, the last week of May. That processing, after the usual restart hiccups, settled down quite quickly. And what was very encouraging for us is we started to see the recoveries that we were expecting. Now, you need to understand that the accelerated plan is, in our business model, we're pushing the oxides to the side. We then go through a transitional zone. And that transitional zone is a mixture of both the oxide and sulfide. But it was in itself historically difficult. And we needed to understand what was causing the difficulty. And having identified the main problem being a mineral called chrysocolla, exclude that from our run-of-mine process material. And having done that, all of a sudden the recoveries start coming up. So we're only a month into processing, but it's very encouraging that that month had sufficient tonnage throughput and sufficient recovery achieved for us to declare it a break-even month, which means that our theories are well-founded, and it's early days yet, but at least from this point forward, we are generating good understanding of the metallurgy as we advance towards the primary sulfides at deeper levels.
And so these mining rates, these will be ramping up. You should be hitting your stride at capacity by Q4.
That's correct. The first job is to create sufficient space to deploy additional equipment into the mining areas. And we're doing that in a phased way. So we started the accelerated plan with two excavators and the associated trucks. At the end of June now, we're deploying a third. And then by the end of the third quarter, we'll be deploying the fourth. And that build-up also allows us sufficient time to get control of the process plant, install a few more redundancies so that the availability of the process plant improves, all the while improving the recoveries as we deepen in the mining operation.
So what are you looking at in terms of production for the second half here now?
We have given guidance of 5,700 tons of copper contained in concentrate. We think that's achievable. It's not a stretch target, but we're not in the stretch target year of our restart of operations. We'd rather bed down a solid operation while we are planning our overall upgrade, which is to be commissioned in next year. So our building blocks are expand the operation, bed down the processing operations that we have at present, and release the upgrade project also fairly soon, and then commission that in the second half of next year.
And what would that potentially mean next year for production there?
Well, at full run rate, the upgraded facility would produce 21,000 tons a year of copper.
Right.
I think it's too early to give clear guidance on 2019 figures, but we'd be commissioning to achieve that sort of ramp up towards the end of 2019.
Is it fair to say that you're pleased, you're encouraged with how the ramp up and how things are coming along at the moment?
Well, it's mining. It's challenging, It's also quite pleasing to see our theories being put into practice and the results predicted coming out of the process plant, because it's easy to see good results on a bench scale, but when it's operating, it's very encouraging when you're getting the same result as predicted.
Just a reminder, you do have an offtake agreement in place for your production here, don't you?
We do. Our offtaker, Fujax, is working closely with us. And they've had to wake up because we're producing quite a lot of copper and concentrate. So there's a little bit of teething problems in the logistics, getting all of this smoothed out, but it's going well so far.
But those teething issues to one side, quite a nice time to be increasing production of copper, given the tightening
Absolutely.
Supply.
It's a tight market. I think the uncertainty in the markets has certainly put a cap on new copper projects developing. And bringing Mowana back into production is very timeous from that point of view.
What's the latest here with Makala? I know you've had a license extension granted.
Well, we're in the process of doing additional work on it. It has a future in around about 5 years' time of being a underground copper producer. So we are busy doing drilling and feasibility work on it in order to prove that future. We're an ambitious bunch. We're going from 12,000 to 20,000 tons or a year of copper. There is scope for further development at Mowana, but at the same time, the Makala prospect needs to be brought to the book. And then we would have a reasonable size operation at the Mowana site.
You got a bit of cash in the bank, you're comfortable there?
It's always tight. Mining is an expensive game, it's capital intensive. We are reasonably financed now. The financing round we did early April certainly made things more possible for us. Our recently released financial results is recognizing
That's right.
The fact that we are a little bit tight, and management will work on that and look at ways and means of reducing our overall risk profile.
You mentioned a moment ago you're an ambitious bunch. All eyes, fair to say, on ramping up production here at Mowana, or are you got an eye out for potentially something else going on?
We would be remiss if we weren't looking, but we also need to make sure that what's in the backyard is well and truly comfortable.
Kevin, great to see you this afternoon. Thank you.
Andrew, thanks very much.